Let's talk about the Super Eagles of Nigeria and a friendly game against Argentina. We'll see Lionel Messi again single-handedly. He said, how can Argentina not bear the World Cup? Took it upon himself and gave us a beast mode performance. It'll be good to see Nigeria take on Argentina, Toby.
Firstly, I want to say kudos to the Federation and the match agent. Thinking ahead, we won't have much, you know, at Africa's next year. There's African qualifiers, and then preparation has started. We would have picked up the World Cup ticket. And a lot of things will come to really play Nigeria, and Argentina is a very big test for Nigeria and also for General Tro. On November 10th, we'll play against Algeria, and then 4 days, you know, later, we'll travel to Russia to play against Argentina. This is a very big game and a big test for the Super Eagles. I mean, brilliant performance. We've seen, you know, General Tro and his boys, you know, in a couple of months. And then this game really come at a very good time to see, you know, how much, you know, we could, you know, perform at the World Cup, especially in the goalkeeping department. Let's see what the likes of Ezequiel will do. I'm really excited also to see the Argentine squad, very, very strong squad in the Messi, you know, Aguero, everyone is available to play Nigeria. So, I mean, also, General Tro also think also to ensure that all these big boys are also available because, you know, this is just a match that will, you know, give you something you will be expecting at the World Cup in Russia. And also, they go be playing in Russia, acclimatization and the stuff like that for the players.
That's right. That's why I was going with Inyobong. Good organization by the NFF. When they do the right things, let's say well done to them.
Absolutely.
I mean, when they're not doing well, we're here to also tell them.
We can throw stones.
We're allowed to throw stones. It's good. Argentina even agreeing to play Nigeria shows they have respect for the Super Eagles and what they're doing now. And again, they're going to play in Russia. Do I have a feel of the soil? Do I have a feel of the you know, the weather, you know, and what it is to play football there? So I think it's a very good one.
Good one for the Nigerian Football Federation. You've got to give them credit because they've done absolutely well in organizing the foresight to organize this friendly match. And it's good to see that the Argentine squad are not taking this match lightly, because if they're taking it lightly, the likes of Messi and Paulo Dybala and Mauro Icardi and Aguero won't be invited for this one. And I'm looking at this one as a dress rehearsal for the World Cup, because I'm sure Gernot Rohr will be looking at this and saying, this is an opportunity to test ourselves against the might of a football superpower. Forget that they struggle to qualify for the World Cup. At the World Cup, when Argentina get to the World Cup, they are top three, top four teams at that World Cup, because they've got the individuals, an absolutely cracking football nation. And it's good to see. I'm not about the results against Argentina. I'm about the performance. Can we go toe-to-toe with a good football side? Because when you go to the World Cup, you're looking at the South Americans, you're looking at the French, you're looking at Germany, you're looking at the Spanish side. And somehow, these sides like to play.
We meet them.
You get to meet them. Yeah. And they play alike. They play fast pace, high tempo, pressing high up the field football. So we've got to test ourselves against this side.
Like,
and
it.
Maybe, just maybe, this is one time that you begin to feel that there's that confidence inspired in you that the Super Eagles can go to the World Cup and really throw the cat among the pigeons.
I totally agree with you. Remember, we played them right there in Brazil.
Yep.
It was a close game.
And yeah, I was about saying they were lucky.
Yeah.
Argentina was lucky in that one. 3-2, it ended. Yeah. But we gave a good account of ourselves. And we showed that, yes, we can actually play football. And Super Eagles technical advisor, Gernot Rohr, has hinted that, look, I don't care what you guys are saying. This is a serious game, and I'm going to play my top players.
Yeah, very, very important. Every player should be available. You know, we've seen a lot of argument about Ezequiel. Vincent should come back. I mean, this is a big game for Ezequiel. This is a big test for him, for all the goalkeepers. I mean, Ezequiel, Dilajiboy, Akpei. If Vincent is not available, you know, this is a, you know, possible goalkeeper at the World Cup. And they're getting games like this. I mean, this is a very good preparation. Leo Balogo, let's see Leo Balogo partnership with Ekong against the Argentines.
That's right.
Let's see Mikel, you know, pull out a great performance in the middle against the Argentines. Let's see Galo against Mascherano. So, I mean, it's a big game. It's a perfect time when our boys are informed also. So, General Tro, and hopefully all our players will be available.
That's right.
I mean, if our players are available, let's sell our big boys against, you know. But I really want to see the likes of Ezequiel we did 45 minutes against Argentina. It will be very interesting.
It will be great, also, honestly. Yeah. It will really be great. I mean, if I were Ezequiel, I'll be calling the manager every day and telling him, boss, I've got to play this game. I've got to be on the same field with Lionel Messi.
Then he'll put you on the bench.
I want to be on the same field with Lionel Messi. I want Lionel Messi to smash it from 30 yards, and I'll get a fingertip save on that one, and the world will stand up for me.
That's
an opportunity, because As a footballer, when you're ambitious, you want to play against the best.
Yeah.
And I can tell you, some of those, the fringe players will be begging the manager, please, I need to be in that squad.
But you need to calm down in this sort of game and be a professional. Mm. Otherwise, you go there and start looking at Messi's boots.
No. Our boys are big boys.
It gives you a good opportunity. You just talked about tipping over a Lionel Messi show. Yeah. And you told the story of Vicente Yama in 2002 when he stopped Paul Scholes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that was what everyone remembered.
And the rest and, is history, like they say.
So it was the platform. Mm. So, yeah, that's a good one. November the 14th. At the Crown Soda Stadium in Russia, Nigeria will take on Argentina. Everyone loves it. Everyone is talking about it. And we're looking forward to Oge Sampaoli, as I've said, to field his biggest players for the November friendly against the Super Eagles. So we love it. It's all about preparing for the World Cup. Hopefully nobody will be injured. Any update on Leon Balogun?
Yep. I heard that it should be in the next 10 days, it should be available.
Okay.
And then that'll be very key. Ah. I mean, we just need to have that set up. I mean, General Trout has done something very key. In our last three games, Omano against Cameroon and against Zambia, we had same set of players starting.
That's
so we need that. I mean, that chain should be available. The one or two, you know, inclusion would be very great. I would love to see this, you know, start this squad, you know, be available against Argentina. It really give us, I mean, a lot of belief going to the World Cup.